Hello everyone, this is me Devashmita Sharkar. Today I am going to start with a new chapter of Social and Political Life Part 2, and this is Chapter 3, How the State Government Works. So let's begin. Here we will be learning about the works of the government. Here we will know some important words which is unknown to many of us. Okay, first we will read this comic strip. Whose responsibility? Hey, look at this. It says that there is a water shortage in our state and the people are falling sick. In many villages, people were found to be drinking unclean water. Streams have dried up and so have tanks. In the worst affected areas, villagers have been carrying water across great distances. People at the district HQ Patalpuram receive water supply once in 3 days. The district hospital is overflowing with patients, a large number of whom are children with acute diarrhea. This comic strip continues. On the TV news, they said 10 people have died from diarrhea. Is that possible? Can one really die from it? Who knows? Just hope I don't get it. That afternoon, my mother said not to have any iced drinks from the market. She gave one of her lectures in this morning. You have to be responsible for your health. Shrin. Ha ha. Suddenly, a woman police stopped her. For what? The road is blocked due to the rally they have been gathered the MLA's residence. Really? Why? Has he done something? The police woman replied. Ha ha. They seem more angry about what he hasn't done. And here is the opposition who is telling that, and we demand that the authorities have taken immediate action to bring the public health situation under control. Our MLA must take the responsibility for this. What a loud voice he has. He must be a leader or something. Shh, I saw him on TV too. He is a member of the opposition. So here we are seeing the word MLA. This word is unknown to many of us. So here we will see who is an MLA. In the above section, you have read about some events in Patalpuram. You may be familiar with the official names such as collectors, medical officers, etc. But have you heard of an MLA and the Legislative Assembly? Do you know the MLA of your area? Can you identify which party she or he belongs to? So the full form of MLA is the members of the Legislative Assembly, and they are elected by the people. They became members of the Legislative Assembly or MLAs and also formed the government. In this way, we can say that MLAs represent people. These are important sentence, and the below example will help you to understand this better. Every state in India has a legislative assembly, and we know each state is divided into different areas of constituencies. For example, look at the map below. It shows that the state of Himachal Pradesh is divided into 68 assembly constituencies. Here is the map. And we can see that the state Himachal Pradesh is divided into 68 constituencies. The people elect one representative who then become a member of the Legislative Assembly or MLA. You would have noticed that people stand for elections in the name of different parties. These MLAs therefore belong to different political parties. Okay, here we can see that four colors are there. Okay, and each color is divided into many parts. and each part is the MLA. So are you sure that in green part everyone will be from the same political party? No. Everyone, most of them can be from different political parties also. Okay. How do people who are MLAs become ministers or chief ministers? A political party whose MLAs have won more than half of the number of constituencies in a state can be said to be in a majority. So, in this example, we are seeing that four colors are there, and in this and among these four colors, green is taking more space than other colors. Okay, so this green is the majority. The political party that has the majority is called the ruling party, and all the members are called the opposition. Okay, so here we can see that the political party that has the majority is called the ruling party. From here, the political party which has more MLAs, which consists of more MLAs in this part, is the ruling party, and other members are known as the opposition. So here we can see that there are results of the assembly elections in Himachal Pradesh in 2017. Political party Bharatiya Janata Party or BJP consists of 44 MLAs. INC or Indian National Congress consists of 21 MLAs. Communist Party of India, Marxist, consists of 1 MLA, and independent who do not belong to any party consists of 2 MLAs. If you add these numbers, you will get 68 MLAs. Candidates from various political parties won the 2017 assembly elections and became MLAs. Since the total number of MLAs in the Legislative Assembly is 68, so the political party who can be the ruling party should have 34 MLAs or more than 34 MLAs. And the Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP, with 44 MLAs had the majority, and it became the ruling party because it has number of MLAs more than 34, and all other MLAs became the opposition. In this case, the Indian National Congress (INC) was the major opposition party since it had the largest number of MLAs after the BJP. Among the opposition were the other parties, including those who have been elected as independent candidates. So here I want to highlight that there are 68 total number of MLAs in the Legislative Assembly. How many assemblies should be needed to get the majority? There is a question, and I have highlighted the portion. The answer of the highlighted portion is the highlighted portion. Okay. Here is some information, and here is some research works also we have to do. You all have to do. Construct a table similar to the one given for the Himachal Pradesh. Okay, we have to construct a table like this. As I live in West Bengal, so I will construct a map like this, by which will show all the divisions. Okay, this part is very, very, very important. This highlighted part. The head of the state is the governor. She or he is appointed by the central government to ensure that the state government works within the rules and regulations of the constitutions. So, the head of the state is the governor, and that governor is appointed by the central government to ensure that the state government works within the rules and regulations of the constitutions. And again, an important term is also there. What is coalition? At times, the ruling party may or may not be a single party, but a group of parties working together. So, if we see that if it is that Bharatiya Janata Party is 44 and Indian National Congress is also 44, so that day what we will do? So Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP and INC is the two ruling party. So there is that government, that type of government is known as coalition. Okay. After the elections, the MLAs belonging to ruling party will elect their leader, who will become the chief minister. In this case, the BJP MLAs choose C. Jairam Thakur as the leader, and he became the chief minister. And he chooses or selects the other people as ministers. And after the elections, it is the governor of the state who appoints the chief ministers and other ministers. We should remember the name, Sri Jairam Thakur. And who is he? He is the chief minister of Himachal Pradesh. The chief ministers and other ministers have the responsibilities of running various governments, departments or ministries. They have separate offices. Legislative assembly is a place where all the MLAs, whether from ruling party or from the opposition, meet to discuss various things. So by reading this portion, we came to know a short definition of legislative assembly. And now we will be knowing a debate, a meeting which is going on the going in the legislative assembly. There is our friend Sujata and many other students from their school travel to the state capital to visit the legislative assembly, which was housed in an impressive building. The children were excited. After security checks, they were taken upstairs. There was a hall from where they could see a large hall below. There were rows and rows of desks. The assembly was going to have a debate or meeting on the current problem. During this time, MLAs can express their opinions and ask questions related to the issues or give suggestions about what should be done by the government. Those who wish to can respond to this. The minister then replies to the question and tries to assure the assembly that adequate steps are taken. The chief ministers and other ministers have to take decisions and run the government. We usually hear about them or see in the news channels or in the newspapers. However, whatever decisions have been taken have to be approved by the members of the legislative assembly. And in a democracy, these members can ask questions, debate an important issue, decide where money should be spent, etc. They have the main authority. Okay, first MLA is speaking now. In my constituency of Akhandagaon, during the last 3 weeks, there were 15 deaths because of diarrhea. I think it is a shame that this government has not been able to check the situation of a simple problem like diarrhea while proclaiming itself to be a champion of technology. I would call the attention of the minister in charge of health to take immediate measures to control the situation. Second MLA is speaking now. My question is, why are government hospitals in such a bad condition? Why is the government not appointing proper doctors and other medical staff in the district? I would also like to know how does government plans to deal with this situation, which is affecting a large number of people and is also spreading. This is an epidemic. Now MLA 3 tells his opinion. My constituency of Tolpatti too has a serious shortage of water. Women travel up to three or four kilometers to collect water. How many tankers have been put into service or supply water? how many wells and ponds have been cleaned and disinfected? MLA 4. I think my colleagues are exaggerating the problem. Exaggerating means making the problem more serious or more effective. The government has taken steps to control the situation. Water tankers have been put into service. ORS packets are being distributed. The government is doing everything possible to help people. MLA 5. We have a poor facilities in our hospitals. There are hospitals that do not have a doctor and no medical staff has been appointed for the last few years. In another hospital, the doctor has gone on a long leave. This is a shame. I think the situation is going from bad to worse. How are we going to ensure that ORS packets reach all the families in the affected areas? MLA 6. The opposition party members are unnecessarily blaming the government. The previous government did not pay any attention to sanitation. We have now taken up a drive to clear the garbage that has been lying around for years. In the earlier section, you have read about a debate in the Legislative Assembly. The members were debating the action taken or not taken by the government. This is because MLAs are together responsible for the work of the government. In common usage, the word government refers to government departments and various ministers who head them. So, the overall head is the chief minister. And more correctly, if we tell a more good definition, this is called the executive part of the government. Okay. And all the MLAs who gather together are known as the legislature. In the above section, we have seen that the MLAs, there are 6 MLAs and they are discussing or debating among the problems, among themselves. And these MLAs are known as legislature because they are gathering together in the legislative assembly to discuss a problem. And they are the ones who authorize the supervise their work. As we saw in the earlier section, it is from among them that the head of the executive or the chief minister is formed. Working of the government. The Legislative Assembly is not only the place where opinions are expressed about the work of the government and action is demanded. We will find newspapers, TV channels and other organizations regularly talking about the government. In a democracy, there are various ways through which people express their views and also take action. Let us look at one such way. Soon after the discussions in the assembly, there was a press conference organized by the health minister. Large number of people from different newspapers were present. The ministers and some other ministers, the government officials were also present. The ministers explained the steps which are taken by the government. Reporters asked many questions at this meeting. These discussions were then reported in different newspapers. The following page has one such report. During the next week, the chief ministers and the minister for health visited Patalpuram district. They went to visit the families who had lost their lives and also visited people in the hospitals. The government announced a compensation for these families. The chief minister also said that he thought of the problem, which is not only one of the sanitation but also of a lack of clean drinking water. He said that a high-level inquiry committee will be asked to look into the needs of the district to provide sanitation facilities and would request the Prime Minister for Public Works to take care of the needs of the proper water supply in the region. As we have seen, Here it show it is saying that following page has one such report, and this is the report. The government smells the garbage. The chief minister promises funds for work. During the last few weeks, there have been many deaths in some districts of our state. There has been a strong reaction that the government has not taken this seriously. The health minister explained today at a press conference that his government has asked all the collectors and the chief medical officers to take urgent measures. The most important problem is that of drinking water. The minister said that they intend to supply drinking water to every village through tanker trucks. The chief minister has promised funds for this work. We also plan to start a campaign to inform people about the steps that can be taken to prevent diarrhea.